Hey guys, my name is Jason with Non-Baker Mining and Metals, and today I want to talk to you a little bit about the ball mills we sell. So this is our 4x8 ball mill, and it's designed to run 2 tons per hour at about a half to three-quarter inch input and discharge about 50 to 60 mesh. The mill is designed to turn between 30 and 32 RPM, and it weighs about 30,000 pounds when it's fully loaded with balls.
To reduce the discharge size of the ball mill, the retention time needs to be increased, and this can be done by decreasing the throughput of material or by decreasing the flow of water through the ball mill. This is the drive mechanism for the ball mill, and this unit is run by a 40 horse, three-phase electric motor. The gearbox reduces the output of the motor. The studs on the side of the drum hold in the liners that are cast manganese for reduced wear on the drum. This is the feed side of the mill, and as you can see, there's a scoop, so when the material enters the drum, it is scooped into the ball mill at an even rate. You can see the access door, which allows for input of a new charge of balls and can also be used to clean out the mill for replacement of the liners. Here is the discharge side of the ball mill, and the material and slurry can be captured and then directed down onto a concentrator.
So this is our 3x6 ball mill. It's designed to take about a half inch feedstock and run it through the mill and discharge about 50 to 60 mesh minus at 1 ton an hour. The ball mill is filled about a third of the way full with balls. It rotates about 35 RPM and discharges the material out here. This is the inside of our 3x6 ball mill, and this is the feed side. And as I pan across the empty mill, you'll see the high manganese cast wear plates for armor that are fully replaceable. And then you get over to the discharge side, and it has a grate to hold in the balls and only discharge the fine material. These are the balls we use in our ball mills, and they're a high chrome alloy for high abrasion resistance. And you add equal amounts of each size ball when you first charge the mill, and then as the balls wear, you just keep putting in larger balls. It runs with a 25 horse three-phase motor. The mill weighs a little more than 3 tons, and you can see how easily I can turn the mill with just one hand. So thanks for watching our video on our ball mills. And if you guys have any questions or are interested to learn more about our ball mills or our products, please give us a call or send us an email. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.